wikiprocedure.com welcomes you for another session on how to apply for a goods carriage permit, that is state permit in Karnataka. The link provided below here will help you in reaching our site wikiprocedure.com and the page Karnataka apply for a goods carriage permit, state permit. And here in this procedure, in this page, we have given detailed procedure along with information and instruction which are useful for an applicant to complete this procedure. Also, we have given a few links for external forms and websites. They are also useful in completing this procedure. The importance of these links will be known to you in the due course of our presentation. Also, you can select the language of your choice from the select language tab, which is provided on the top right corner of our page. So select the language of your choice to understand this procedure easily. List of items covered in the session today: need for goods carriage permit, documents required, how to apply, eligibility, validity, fees, processing time, offices and contacts, online resources and other information. Today this procedure is sponsored by wikiprocedure.com for you. Let us find the need for goods carriage permit, that is state wise. Meaning, whenever we used to send any of our luggages from one place to another place for a reason of relocating, we might require a vehicle to carry our assets. So these vehicles should get this permit. Not only that, when a company produces a product and it needs to deliver it to a different point, then they require a service of a vehicle which has the goods carriage permit within the state limit for transporting these kind of goods. Without that permit, if someone is transporting the goods, it is unlawful and they have to pay the penalty. Goods carriage permit is issued to an applicant to use this motor vehicle for carriage of goods for hire or a reward, or for the carriage of goods for or in connection with a trade or business carried by the applicant himself. In general, there is no restriction for grant of permits to goods vehicles because it is the need for a owner of the vehicle to use it according to the requirement. Vehicles with this permit be used only in the specified area or a specific route or routes in the state. That goods of a specified nature shall not be carried. If government provides any restriction of carrying such goods which are exempted from the permit, you should not carry it. And you should have a fixed rate which is generally fixed or been organized by the body for that. The age of the vehicle should not exceed 12 years for getting this permit. Let us see the documents required. You have to use the online form downloadable page link provided here to download the appropriate form for this procedure. The first link will give access to the Transport Department of Karnataka portal, where you can download the respective form which is listed here. Also, Parivahan portal form which is provided in here. From here also you can download the respective forms. Respective application forms has to be completed. You can obtain it from the RTO too. Registration certificate of the vehicle, fitness certificate of the vehicle, proof of payment of tax for the current quarter, insurance certificate of the vehicle, payment of green tax wherever applicable as per requirement. Affidavit sworn by the applicant before an executive or a first class judicial magistrate or a notary public. Passport size photos too. No objection certificate from the financier if the vehicle concerned is covered by HBA, these are hypothecation. Pollution under control certificate, age proof, any of the following like school certificate or a birth certificate. Proof of address, any one of the following to be produced like ration card, Aadhaar card, electoral roll, LIC policy, passport, payslip issued by government office or a local body, or the documents required for this procedure. Let us see how to apply in person. To apply for a goods carriage permit state-wise in Karnataka, the applicant has to approach the RTO office concerned for his area to apply. Don't worry if you don't know the address of your RTO office, please use the link provided here to reach the contact page of the Karnataka State portal, wherein you can filter further to note down the address concerned for your local RTO office. As I said, you can use the two links provided here to download the form applicable for your requirement. Complete the respective application form without any mistakes. Make sure that you have all the required documents, because missing out one document, your application stands rejected. The applicant should make sure they are eligible for the process and then they can apply. Application forms can be obtained directly from the RTO office on your visit. Please fill them without any mistake and attach all the requirement and submit this bunch to an officer there. He will mark you the amount on the counter in which you need to pay. Go to the counter, stand in a queue and pay the fees and submit your documents on your turn. Once the authorities accept your documents, they will start processing your application. Important verification of the permit, including the check inspection of the vehicle condition, body arrangements and other mandatory requirement for the vehicle setup will be taken care, scrutinized. After checking the vehicle for its correctness and other appropriate requirement, the application will be processed further to issue you goods carriage permit, state permit. Eligibility: you should be the owner of the vehicle in order to apply for this procedure. The age of the vehicle should not exceed 12 years for goods carriage. Validity: permit is valid, usually valid for 5 years. The renewal of permit can be obtained with vehicle fitness certificate FC obtained from the authorities of the respective RTO. The age of the vehicle is also considered to restrict the validity of the permit. Validity differs with the type of vehicle and also for the load the vehicle can manage. Fees: RTO authorities will guide you on the fees which you need to pay for such service. Don't worry, we have provided a link here which will give you access to the page where you have different kind of services and the amount collected as fees for these services. With this information provided, you will be better informed about the fees which you need to pay for the service. Processing time: it takes 5 working days to get the permit. Offices and contacts: Commissioner for Transport and Road Safety, TTMC Building, Shanti Nagar, Bangalore 27. PRO phone detail and email details are provided here for your clarification of doubts. Also, the link provided below here will give access to the contact information of the RTO office, which we have already discussed. Online resources: all these links provided here will give direct access to the web portals which we have used for completing this procedure. We know the importance of these details provided with the help of these websites, so we have provided these websites as link at appropriate places for your convenience in saving your time. Other information: holder of the permit shall furnish to the regional authority such periodical return statistics and other information as the state government may from time to time as prescribed. FC fall clearance is a process meant for reviewing the condition of the vehicle by the RTO authorities. Hope this video helped you. Don't forget to give us a like and hit subscribe to our channel for more such videos. Thank you once again for visiting wikiprocedure.com to know how to apply for goods carriage permit, state permit in Karnataka.